well. Hang on a minute. Hang on. Yeah. Hello? Yeah. Could you call me back in a minute? Call me back in about 2 minutes, yeah? Yeah, it's just that I'm in the middle of doing my video diaries now. Yeah, we're on record. Yeah. What? Yeah. I will talk about it, alright? Okay. Bye. Right, before episode 2 of Coventry City Diaries part 2 can begin, I'd just like to advertise my band, The Athelstons. We are on MySpace, so you can listen to our songs. If you're viewing on YouTube, click the link below the screen in the descriptions box. And if you're viewing on Facebook, view on the right hand side of the screen. I think the link is there for you to click on to access the MySpace page. Thanks for listening, and now Coventry City Diaries part 2.
Good place to be. Don't believe that. Just think it's a moment and it's never gonna be all for me. Don't believe that. Oh no. Cause it's never gonna be all for me. Broken world. Oh. It's in my bag.
Hello. Well. That was a massive relief, wasn't it? Getting our first win of the season. And I somehow had a feeling that we wouldn't get our first win till about September. Obviously, with the team we've got, we wouldn't be able to start off brilliant with that team because some of them have never played together. So they've taken a long time to, you know, get to know each other, gel together, work together. And now it's starting to pay off as we've gone 3 games undefeated. So, yeah, first of all, I didn't go to the game. I'm saving my money because I'm going on holiday in less than 2 weeks. So it was either do that or go to the Ipswich game on Monday night. And that's a lot closer for me to travel, as I live in Romford. Yeah, moving on to the game.
First of all, forgot to tell you, I watched the game online on German TV, German channel, I think it was.
And I just loved how the commentators pronounced the names of the managers. Was it? Derby County manager, Nigella Clough. Coventry City manager, Candy Thorne. Candy Thorne. Oh God, it was funny. Them all speaking in German and then saying the Coventry players' names in English. And they were that knowledgeable, they even called us the Sky Blues, not Coventry City. Yeah. So anyway, whilst having the pleasure of watching it on probably German TV, I also had the underprivilege of watching a really crap first half. And I'm sure you'll agree as well, it was crap. On the pitch. I know off the pitch there was trouble in the crowds, but I don't really have a position to say on that because I wasn't there. Anyway, moving on to the second half. Cody McDonald
He didn't really get into the game that much, but then again, it's only his first game, so he's got plenty of time. And so has Roy O'Donovan, because he hasn't played that many games for us. It will take him a while. But then again, I do have to once again point the finger at Lukas Jukovic. Because that boy has got a serious problem with scoring from open play. I mean, alright, yes, he scored a penalty against Derby. And yes, he did score two goals from open play against Palace and Middlesbrough. But they were somewhat helped by defenders. Watch him again and you'll see what I mean. And I think... I know the club is a bit skint at the minute, but I think they should seriously invest in buying Lukas Jukovic a fucking sat-nav to guide him to hit the target, because he's got a problem with that big time. I mean, I really hope he does it. I want him to, but he keeps missing the target, and when he does hit the target, he hits it straight at the keeper or the defender. Like, there was one chance on Saturday, he was through on goal, he miskicked it, and then the second time, yeah, they call it a shot at goal, he practically passed it to the defender, I think. That's how soft it was and easy. But anyway, on to the positives. The back four played really, really well. Hang on a minute. Hang on. Yeah, hello? Yeah, could you call me back in a minute? Call me back in about 2 minutes, yeah? Yeah, it's just that I'm in the middle of doing my video diaries now. Yeah, we're on record. Yeah, what? Yeah. I will talk about it, alright? Okay. Bye. What was I talking about? Yeah, the back four were really, really good, I thought. Cyrus Christie, brilliant. Richard Keogh actually had a good game for once. Chris Hussey was really good as well. The other players, Biggie Romana, he's very good in. And he is now showing that he has passion for the team. You could tell that by at the end of the game. He was on his knees thanking the Lord up above that he finally got his first 3 points for Coventry City. That boy has got passion. And we've got to love him. Carl Baker, really good as well. His goal was fantastic. First time volley. I think it was first time volley. Yeah, it was. But I just wish he could do that more and more often. Shame it was 14,000 again, but then again, that's what our attendances seem to be these days. Especially if it's on telly. So we can't complain too much. And it was a good day all round. Oh yes, Chris Dunn, the substitute keeper. I thought he was excellent. I thought, well, there is a massive difference between him and Joe Murphy. For starters, Chris Dunn can catch a ball. Second of all, Joe Murphy's fucking shit. That's the comparison. So, as a result of the 2-0 win over Derby, I think we should stick with the team that we've got and take it from there and don't break what works. And hopefully the other injured players we have will be back very soon. Yeah, so the next episode I'll be doing is Ipswich away next week. I'll be going to that, even though it's on telly. It's going to be £29 on the door, but never mind. So that's the next episode I'm going to do. And I know I've only made 2 episodes so far this series. But trust me, I'm going... This series, I have vowed that I will make more episodes than Carrie Katona's had next chapters on ITV2. Fuck me, that's a challenge. So I'll see you again for next week of episode 3. Ta-da.